In this video, I'm going to be working out an individual limit problem. It's going to be a trig problem, and I am going to use this property, the limit as x approaches 0 of kx over the tangent of kx equaling 1. All right, this is a limit that can be worked out algebraically to prove that, because it's not typically given to you in a calculus book. However, I do allow my students to use this, because this is a known. As long as I've got kx and kx matching there with the same constants, all right, this does turn out to be one every time, so I allow my students to use it. So in this limit, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to do a direct substitution to make sure that we really have that indeterminate form. So I'm going to plug 0 in, and that's going to give me a 0 to the third on the top, and then I'll have tangent cubed of 0 on the bottom. Tangent of 0 is 0. Cubing, it's still going to give me 0, so I am going to have 0 over 0. So this limit does give us that indeterminate form. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to algebraically manipulate this so that I get this quantity so that I can very easily calculate this limit. Now, we do have an x to the third in the top, and we've got this tangent of 2x raised to that third power there, so I've got three of those as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this limit up into three individual fractions that are being multiplied together. So I'm going to do the limit as x approaches 0 of x over tangent of 2x times x over the tangent of 2x times x over tangent 2x. Excuse me. All I did was break this rational expression up into three different fractions that are multiplied together. And then you can multiply it back, make sure you get that original fraction, and then you know that you have broken it up successfully. All right, now, looking at this property over here, I'm really close. I have a 2x here, but I have an x in the top. I need 2s in the top to be able to say each one of these limits are 1. So we can multiply by a form of 1, and it's not going to change my equation. So since I have a 2 down here and I want a 2 in the top, I'm going to choose to multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. Same thing with this one. I have a 2 in the bottom. I want that 2 in the top, so I'm going to choose to multiply by 2 over 2. Same thing on this one. I'm going to choose to multiply by 2 over 2. All right, now each one of these 2s on top have to stay, because all I'm going to do is move them in front of the x. So I have 2x on top and 2x on the bottom. That would give me that kx, kx that I need. All right, now these 2s, 2 times 2 times 2, that's going to give me an 8. I'm going to take all three of these and pull them out in front. Now, they are in the denominator, so when I pull them out, I'm really pulling out a 1/8. Okay, so you got to make sure that you're not going to just pull it out as a whole number. Those 2s were in the bottom, so I'm pulling it out in the bottom. So then I'm going to have a 1/8 on the outside times the limit as x approaches 0 of, because that 2 is there now, I have a 2x over the tangent of 2x times, same thing with the middle one, a 2x over the tangent of 2x. And then on the last one, 2x over the tangent of 2x. All right, I can take the limit of each one of these individually, so I could write that. If we wanted to write that step, I usually allow my students after some time to skip that step. I know this goes to 1, this goes to 1, and this goes to 1. So I have a 1/8 times 1 times 1 times 1, which gives me just an overall answer to the limit as 1/8. Definitely, thanks for watching. If the videos are helping you, please be sure and share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks.